afternoon. Let me start by thanking you very much for having me here today to speak to you on a very important topic. At this moment in history, our state stands at a crossroads. Voters are about to decide what kind of court system Iowans will have in the future. Now, you may be thinking that I'm overstating the significance of the upcoming retention elections of 74 Iowa judges. I am not. This election is obviously important for the 74 judges on the ballot, but it's even more important for you, Iowans who depend on the courts to protect their rights and to provide a fair and effective forum for the resolution of disputes. So as we approach election day, it is important to discuss and understand the role of the court and the judges who work in those courts. Public debate about the court system and the merit of court decisions is a healthy aspect of society. However, some of the current debate shows a fundamental misunderstanding among a number of people about the role, authority, and vital importance of Iowa's fair and impartial courts. In order to appreciate the value of our merit selection system of selecting judges, it's important to have an accurate understanding of the role of the courts. So today, I plan to begin my remarks by addressing some of these misconceptions about courts and court decisions, particularly court decisions involving the interpretation of the Constitution. Let's begin with the Constitution. We, the people of the state of Iowa, created a government under the rule of law when we adopted the Iowa Constitution. The rule of law is a system of self-government in which persons, including the government, are accountable under the law. The Constitution sets forth the fundamental rules and principles that govern our citizens and our government. In fact, the Iowa Constitution expressly states, "This Constitution shall be the supreme law of the land, and any law inconsistent therewith shall be void." Well, what if a citizen thinks a law adopted by the legislature violates the citizen's constitutional rights? Who decides whether the legislature's law is unconstitutional? The courts. Because the judicial branch is responsible for resolving disputes between citizens and their government. Nonetheless, some persons have recently claimed that courts have no power or authority to review the constitutionality of statutes. This view demonstrates a misunderstanding about the role of the courts. Judicial review of the constitutionality of statutes is one of the most important functions of the courts in our democracy. The authority of the courts to declare unconstitutional statutes void and unenforceable was settled 200 years ago by the United States Supreme Court in a landmark case, Marbury versus Madison. Since the Marbury case, our federal and state courts are routinely called upon to support the Constitution by determining whether a statute or even a local ordinance violates any provision of the Constitution. Now, I must emphasize the courts do not take the power of judicial review lightly. When analyzing the constitutionality of statutes, courts try to construe a statute in a manner that will avoid a constitutional infirmity. Even so, there are well-defined limits to how far a court may go to save a statute. When the Supreme Court finds that a law fails to meet the requirements of our statute, of our Constitution, the court must declare the law void. In doing so, the court does not assume the powers of other branches of government. It exercises its own authority. The court is not legislating from the bench. It is resolving a dispute between the parties by declaring the legislature's act unenforceable because it violates the will of the people as expressed in the people's constitution. And finally, the court does not overstep its constitutional role when it declares an unconstitutional statute void. To the contrary, the court fulfills its constitutional role in doing so. Of course, even when courts fulfill their constitutional duty, they are not immune from criticism. I'm going to read you three comments about a court decision and ask if you think these sound familiar. The court threw out sound judicial precedent, repudiated the greatest legal minds of our age, and lowered itself to the level of common politics. The justices abandoned their role as judges of the law and organized themselves into a group of social engineers. The decision of the court is a flagrant abuse of judicial power. This sort of criticism is certainly prevalent today. However, you may be surprised to learn that these particular comments were aimed at the United States Supreme Court after its 1954 decision in Brown versus Board of Education, which struck down government-sanctioned segregation in public schools. The unanimous Brown decision unleashed a firestorm of criticism. Of course, the Brown decision today is universally respected. But at the time the Supreme Court decided the Brown case, the court had three justices from the Deep South: Hugo Black from Alabama, Tom Clark from East Texas, and Stanley Reed from Kentucky. They had to have known that the Brown decision would make them unwelcome at home, and it did. Nevertheless, they did not let that pressure influence their decisions on this important civil rights case. I mention the Brown case to illustrate the fact that complaints about judicial review of constitutional issues are not uncommon or new, nor are these complaints confined to one political point of view. Early in the last century, President Theodore Roosevelt and like-minded progressive politicians condemned the federal courts for invalidating popular legislative reforms. Nearly 30 years later, liberal politicians denounced United States Supreme Court rulings that invalidated some of President Roosevelt's New Deal policies in the 1930s. Conservatives denounced the Supreme Court rulings in the 1970s that upheld a right to privacy. And more recently, liberals have condemned the U.S. Supreme Court decisions that struck down gun regulations and campaign finance laws as unconstitutional. But despite the political fallout of any particular court decision, judges must follow the Constitution, which states that a law inconsistent with the Constitution must be declared void. This requirement of our Constitution contains no exceptions. So even though a law may be supported by strong and deep-seated traditional beliefs and popular opinion, if it violates the Constitution, the court must declare it void. Well, why is it important that courts fulfill this constitutional role? Because the courts must, under all circumstances, maintain the supremacy of the Constitution in order to protect our form of government, the rule of law, and the rights and freedoms of all our citizens. The current debate in Iowa about the courts has led some people to propose that Iowa needs to change the way it selects judges. Before I comment on that proposal, I want to discuss briefly the current process for selecting judges.